Hey guys, and welcome. Today I want to dedicate the video to introducing a new feature we have invented pretty much for Popometer.io, which is dedicated to helping you coach yourself better, faster, and easier. So let me try to get there. When I do a coaching, of course, we always go through a lot of detail, right? We go through every corner, we go through every braking zone, every acceleration, how much is steered, when the gears are changed, and how all these things act together, and what does it do to the car, where it's placed, how much it rotates, how it stops the rotation, how you as a driver sometimes create car behavior that you didn't actually want or yet you didn't expect, and your brain can't figure out which input does what. We do all that in the coaching. But of course, that's very time consuming. And in the coaching also, often I share so much that it actually becomes too much for the client to put into practice. And that's why I started narrowing things down quite a bit different in the coachings for people to have something to refer to and much more easily put into practice on the track after a session without having to remember so much, right? Because if you had that coaching 1 hour long and there's like 5 or 10 pieces of information per corner that you now have to change, this is pretty much impossible, right? Because everything happens so fast, it's likely not going to work that way. When you move your braking point, you move the trail braking initiation, you move your apexes, you move the steering. And I said this for like 5 or 10 seconds, but this means the corner is 6 seconds behind you already by now. So we need something easier in order to A, remember, but B, to put into practice and kind of see on the track as well. So what I've done in the coaching as a result is just giving people 2 or 3 references per corner that they should be aimed for to get closer to my references. And these 2 or 3 points are the apex, and there can be 2 of them, and the slowest point in the corner. So that's why you see it can turn out to be 2 or 3. Because some corners do have just 1 apex, some corners do have 2 apexes. So let me show you what I mean. Actually, that's not what I mean. This is what I mean. So this is the normal thing you are seeing on Popometer. Now we've taken that, what I learned in the coachings, what I started to give people at their hands, fingertips, whatever you want to call it, into automatically provided information for every lap you do, for every pro lap we've ever recorded. You are now getting these 3 points I just mentioned that we call track marks. So in purple, we now have the apexes. And in blue, we have the slowest points in the corner. So the client here was like 4 seconds, I think, off the pace over the course of a lap. This was Audi on the Nürburgring. This is T7 with the aggressive presets in something like 25 degrees or so. Doesn't matter. And the only thing after everything I gave him was to try to replicate these points. Okay, so what do I mean? There is a first apex. What does apex mean? Apex means this is the point where we are the closest to the inside of a corner. Then we have a slowest point in the corner, which means where we stop decelerating, where we stop rolling, where we stop braking, which also means from there, the speed increases again. This means we need throttle. And more importantly, we need enough throttle. Here at the dotted line shows that we need enough throttle for the car to actually start accelerating, because there are many ways in ACC, if you look at the solid line here, the speed is actually decreasing when there's 40, 50% throttle applied, because you're kind of only stopping the engine brake from not slowing the car down further. So the important thing here is enough throttle to accelerate. And then there is a second apex later in that corner that is also a target. Now, if we bring back the marks of the client here, you'll see the first apex is missing. So he was never really close to the inside there, kind of missed that apex. There could be various reasons, but we don't want to look into the inputs here too much. Of course, they matter. They play a role, but we just want to find a way how does he get the car to clip that first apex here? And the second information that lies in that is the car is tight once, but this is not where it's the slowest, okay? So when you're going for the inside here in that corner, there is still plenty of time to go to reach the slowest point in the corner. And we can actually measure that. This is something like 2,420 meters on the track, and the apex is more like 2,455 meters or something. So there's still a good 20, 30 meters of slowing down the car after hitting the first apex until you really want to be the slowest in the corner. And you could say this is also pretty much the middle of the corner, slightly before that. It will differ depending on car temperature, skill of the driver, but also just differ between every lap, right? The importance is that this patterns remains the same. So a first apex, a widest, slowest point in the corner, and then we come back to a second apex later on in the corner as an ideal way. And if we bring back up the marks of the client, you can see first apex was missed. The slowest point in the corner is coming a bit too early. And then there's still two thirds of the corner left to accelerate through. And that is something the car just cannot do. You're asking it to accelerate, you're asking it to corner. And that often leads to the car also coming to the second apex much too early. And then there is a lot of corner left where you can't really put the power down, and it takes forever for the corner to end. And then you lose a lot of speed and lap time onto the straight here and for the entirety of the straight. So the target here of the client would need to be, let's clip that first apex there, right? So sooner or later, you notice when the braking point is already very similar, which you can see here, there isn't really a difference. The only way to get the car to the inside is to kind of respond to the steering input by also releasing the brake, which automatically means, hey, I need to start the trail braking to allow the car to start coming to the inside here. And that's not really a problem because I still have plenty of time to get rid of additional speed later on in the corner. There was just 20, 30 meters more until which you really want to be the slowest in that corner, which is then roughly in the middle, about 80 kilometers in this case. Even on my laps, this will change. This will go up 2 kilometers, go down 2 kilometers, depending how I hit it. It's completely fine. We're just trying to aim to get close to that, close to the point, close to the gap we have to the inside, and close to the speed that is happening there. And from that point onwards, we're cutting back to the inside for a late second apex. And just sorting out that first apex here, keep slowing down until the middle of the corner. This will automatically sort a lot of the exit issues that were there before. So what I want to achieve as a coach here is that you don't think about too much while driving, because thinking while driving often really is a problem because there's no time to think. All you can do is act and respond to the car, and everything has to be super fast. So the less we have to think, the faster we'll have to go. And I think if you just go to the track and can start thinking about, okay, remember, I want to be tight, I want to be wide, where I also want to be the slowest, and then I want to be tight again in that corner. So let's quickly have a look how this is supposed to look in the game. This is the exact lap of myself here. I'm just trying to show you the precision, really, that we have achieved with the tool. And that is by just hovering over the marker here, and that tells you gap to the white line is 46 centimeters measured from the middle of the front tire, because this is the value that ACC kind of puts out in the shared telemetry. So half a meter plus minus. It's not endlessly precise, it's quite precise. So half a meter here, and well, pretty much zero clipping the inside white line there even. So if we then take it to the game and have a look where the car is going, slow motion, you can see we're going for the inside white line, but we're never actually clipping it. So this is pretty much where we are the closest. And if we fly around the car and just have a look where the tire actually is, the middle of the tire, you can see this is where the tire is. This is where we're measuring. And this is pretty much half a meter to the white line start of the curb, kind of. And then if we roll it forward, this also means we're still decelerating to 113 here. Then the car is running a bit wide still, and we are still slowing down, brakes still applied, car still slowing down. We saw 80 was the apex, or not the apex, was the slowest speed earlier, which is about now. And there's also the short shift happening. Power is being applied. We are very far away from the inside curb now, putting the power down. Now the car starts coming back to the inside with the aggressive throttle. The rear end rotates, and now we are going for that second apex at the exit of the corner, and we are just waiting for the inside wheel to clip the white line. And if we just look at the middle of the tire, that really is just about behind or on the white line there. So you can see the reference we have there is quite good, plus minus a few centimeters. And that hopefully allows you to extract your information from the telemetry much quicker for like the big chunks of lap time that you are still missing, and don't actually have to go into all the detail, don't have to watch hours of the telemetry. You just take these points, the apex, the slowest point, and potentially if it's a long corner, there's going to be a second apex, and you only work towards these when driving. And I really do hope that this is having as much impact for you as it is having for a lot of people I am coaching. And so please let me know in the comments if you think that feature is useful, what you might need additionally, and how much you're improving with this. This is a subscription feature on popometer.io. So if you don't have one yet, maybe it's about time to get it. Comes with a lot of discounts for the data packs or the bundles that we now have for various cars. My by now maybe famous Porsche bundle, but there's also Aston, Ferrari, Lambo, Mercedes by UOL. I think other cars too, and if they're not there yet, they're certainly coming. So make sure to check it out and let me known, then we'll see you very soon. Bye.